Good morning, and welcome to Battered Arena with Doc Stout. I've done a lot of talking lately about how many classes, and I think a couple times I referred to all 10 classes. Imagine my surprise when I realized that there were only 9. So, we have the final class for Battered Arena. I only had to reroll once in order to get it to come up. So, we have Anduin Wrynn, the Priest. The light shall bring victory. Hero power is frequently unexciting, just restore 2 health. It does get you around other hero powers sometimes, but here we go. Alright, so we've got the Secret Keeper, who, if I get a lot of secrets, is actually pretty sweet for a one drop. Got the Injured Blade Master, who normally I don't like at all, but he deals 4 damage to himself, but I could heal him. Or the Gadgetzan Auctioneer. Whenever I cast a spell, draw a card. These are all really, really good. Although I think Secret Keeper is more situationally good. So I either want a 3-drop who I can heal. He's still got 4. He's a 4/3 who can become bigger. Or card draw when I cast spells. I think because I'm a priest, I'm actually going to take the Blade Master, which I prefer card advantage typically, but we'll see if I come to regret that decision. Abusive Sergeant, Mind Blast, or Divine Shield. Abusive Sergeant is conditionally good. He's a 2-1, but he can give somebody else +2 attack for a turn, allowing weaker guys to trade up. Scarlet Crusader is a 3-1 with Divine Shield. No haste or anything, so depending on who I get matched up with, they could just pop the shield and kill it. Or Mind Blast, which is a straight up 5 damage to the enemy hero. Mind Blast, I think I'm just going to take because it's a fair finisher, and it is a less conditional card than the other two. Mad Bomber, what bombs at midnight? I like him, he's a 3-2, he does 3 damage. However, sometimes he can hit you, he can hit your guys when you don't want him to. There are situations where you wouldn't want to play him. Or I could take a 7-7 for 7 or a 6-7 for 6. Because he comes down a turn earlier, I think I'm just going to take the Boulder Fist Ogre. We've already discussed why I don't like the Blue Gill Warrior and other episodes. He does have charge, but he's just a 2-1, and there's way too many removal spells that can get value off of killing one toughness guy. Raid Leader is situationally very good. If you have lots of other guys, he can turn everybody into a threat. But he doesn't buff toughness. He just buffs attack. That's fine. I think I'm just going to take another Mind Blast. Ooh, Undertaker. Now, Undertaker is a threat that must be answered if you can manage to draft things that have Death Rattle. He gets out of control very quickly, and he starts as a 1-2. We've already passed on a Scarlet Crusader. Flesh-Eating Ghoul, I like him a lot in Constructed. I've taken him a few times in arenas, if you've been watching the episodes. He hasn't actually done that much for me, but he is another must-answer threat. I think I'm going to take the Undertaker, which will definitely change what picks I take for the rest of this. So now I'm going to be looking for things with possible Death Rattle abilities. We've already passed on Flesh Eating Ghoul. Power Word Shield is fine. It replaces itself and gives +2 health. I think I want the Youthful Brewmaster, though. He's good to exploit Enter the Battlefield effects, and he can also save a guy. Or, like, if somebody gets silenced. Mana Addict, Imp Master, or Cold Light Oracle. I don't like the Oracle at all. Imp Master's fine, I guess. Let's, man, I don't have any spell. Oh, I've got a couple of Mind Blasts. Yeah, Mana Addict's fine. Still nothing, nothing coming up giving me, any of my Death Rattle abilities that I'm looking for. Raid Leader and Frostwolf Grunt aren't that great. I think I'm just going to take an Archmage. Alright, so we have our first Death Rattle, even though it's bad for us. Still a 4-4 for 3. It's fine. Alright. Here we go. Shadow Form. I can give my change my hero power from heal 2 to deal 2. Mountain Giant is kind of a narrow card in this format. If I can fill up my hand, I can cast an 8/8 for really cheap. Blood Knight, once again, very situational. Shadow Form looks like a clear winner here. Okay, now, Sinjin Shieldmaster. Normally, I'd just say, no, I'm not going to take the Leper Gnome, but he does give additional value to my Undertaker. Do I have any taunters? No. You're going to find fewer good taunters that are better than Sinjin Shieldmaster, though. If I'm not going to take a one toughness creature who buffs my Undertaker, I'm certainly not going to take one who doesn't. I think Shield Bearer is just bad. Take a Lord of the Arena. My six drop slot is getting crowded. Here we go. Here's a taunter who has Death Rattle. I don't have weapons. Spiteful Smith is not good for Priest. Frost Elemental's fine, but I already have 3 6 drops. Unstable Ghoul is a win. I don't really like any of these guys in this deck, but I guess the least of three evils is the Mad Bomber. We got 2 6 drops and a Power Word Shield. At this point, my 6 drop slot is so crowded that I risk just having my opening hand clogged with them, so I guess I gotta take this. I've been blown out so many times by Mind Control played on me in this series. Man, I want to take the Loot Hoarder, but Mind Control is so awesome. Northshire Cleric is a card advantage card that must be answered. I think I like it even better. Oof. Oh, this is tough. You know, I have a lot of 1 and 2 drops. Normally I just snap take the Northshire Cleric, but I think I want some removal. Like Venture Company Mercenary. I'm not impressed with the other two. Yeah, it's fine. Man, he gives me additional value out of my Undertaker. If I have any secrets, he's awesome, but if I don't get any, he's just a 2-2 for 2. I think I gotta take the Silence. Alarmobot, not impressing me. Murlocs in general, I love them in Constructed, not so much in Arena. I think it's an Azure Drake. Holy Nova or Shadow Word Pain? I think Holy Nova. Good possible, like, mass removal. Now, this is interesting, because all of these cards are pretty good. Silence a Minion for 0. Mind Vision to steal their best card, or Shadow Word Pain. I think I'm going to take the Mind Vision. I've never played with it. Circle of Healing, 4 health to all minions. Pretty good with Shadow Form. Oh no, that's Akanai Shadow Priest. I would need to get to make that good. Well, if I get an Akanai Shadow Priest, I'll regret passing on this, but I think I'll just take the Thought Steal. I think we just straight up take another Unstable Ghoul. Divine Spirit's sweet, but it requires me to have a creature worth doubling their health. Got a bunch of 6 drops already. Mind Blast number 3 it is. Frostwolf Grunt is not good. Dread Corsair is great if you use weapons. Acolyte of Pain wins. 4 more. See, now if I'd taken the card that doubles health, this guy's really good. I mean, I do have a Power Word Shield, so I guess he's good enough anyway. Mind Games? Or Big Game Hunter or Doomsayer? I'm not quite controlling enough to take the Doomsayer, but it's either a BGH or Mind Games. Yeah, that word random, meh. It could be a blowout, but it could do nothing. It could grab a Murloc or something. I think I'm going to take the BGH. I don't like these guys, so I may as well just take a Loot Hoarder. Demolisher and Bloodsail Corsair don't do much for me, so Shadow Madness it is. And there's the deck. Alright, got a few ways to buff Undertaker, and he's a pretty scary threat, even if I didn't. I don't know how I feel about this deck. Certainly not the best I've ever drafted, but let's see how it runs. As has been true for this whole series, I don't have the laptop open for chat, so thank you for watching if you're live on Twitch. My apologies for not participating in the chat. If you notice me make mistakes in the drafting or in the play, please check me out over on YouTube, leave me some comments. I'd love to be less bad at this format. Alright, first opponent up. Priest versus Warlock. Alright.
The light shall bring victory.
Unstable Ghoul sounds good. Boulder Fist Ogre has to go for sure. Do I keep the Shadow Madness or get rid of it? We have no play for turn one. That's probably fine, yeah. That's awkward. It's still not a play for turn one, but it is a spell.
I smell blood.
We coin immediately. If he wants to kill this guy, that's fine by me. Just develop the board a little bit and pass. I can always heal him if I need to. I'm technically winning. What you gonna do, bud? You have elected to kill him. You have not elected to kill him. That seems very silly.
What a rush.
All right, there we go. Get in there for some damage. He's gonna dig for more cards. I think. Well, let's see. What do I got here? I could just use all four, grab his creature, and hit for a bunch. I think I want to slow roll that, though.
I wonder.
Just play another Taunter. If he kills it, he kills it. At least it'll use a card. He's accumulating cards. I wonder if he took a giant. Now I think I can grab his guy and maybe I get the spiders? That seems sweet. I totally get the spiders.
What a rush.
Yeah. Okay, he did have a mountain giant.
Why do you call?
All right, so I got to do 3 damage here. Yeah, let's just do that. I think you've outlived your usefulness. We can get you back. Swing with everything. And I think it's time to mad bomb. Well, that's just lucky. Better lucky than good sometimes, I guess. Now, when he kills this, I'm going to lose a bunch of guys, but that's okay. And he's going to enrage.
I will enjoy watching you die. Avast, matey!
Okay, he just played a lot of guys. So, I've got 7 here. Kill both of those to get rid of his fell guard. He swings back and hits the Sinjin Shieldmaster. Does anything good happen out of this?
Tadingo! Yes.
Mind if I roll knee?
Challenge accepted.
Yeah, I guess we just kill this guy and kind of tempo ourselves. Hurts.
Join or die.
Oh boy, that's bad. He'll be able to. Oh, he's just gonna hit me twice. That's fine.
For the crusade.
That's kind of a cool. Oh, I see what he's gonna do. Get some more cards. Okay. So, I think I need to play something big enough to do some damage.
I must consider.
And then stall.
The gates are open.
Yeah, because I want to finish him off with a mind control. If he doesn't have any taunters, I probably just win. Are you gonna Defender of Argus? No. I'm gonna draw cards. That seems fine. Let's see here. Play here. Alright, my optimal thing happening here is that he actually leaves his mountain giant. Oh god. That's a lot of mountain giant. If he doesn't kill both my guys, I pretty much win on the spot. He naturally has to kill that. Okay, he just does kill one of my... There we go. I just have to survive a turn, it looks like. We Holy Nova? And... He's at 7. Heal myself. And shadow form.
Job done.
Now he has to play a taunter, or he's just dead. It's as though he heard me. Alright, well, even if he plays a taunter, can I kill him? I could do... Yeah, I can kill him. Mind Blast. And then Hero Power. Alright. Yeah, Priest is one of the classes I'm least experienced with. Most of my classes are at in the level 20s to level 30s. I think Priest and Shaman are the exception. So, in my last class, I'm up one win. That's pretty good so far. So that means there will be at least two more episodes before I do the big pack opening for all 9 packs. I'd like to thank everyone who watched this episode, and as I have said, there are 8 other classes in this series. If you miss a series on Twitch, or you're just tuning into me on YouTube maybe, you can find all of my archives on the YouTube channel at docstat076. If you like the video, please follow me on Twitch, subscribe to me on YouTube, click that like button, it helps me out quite a bit, and if you see any mistakes in how I'm playing or how I'm drafting, please leave me a comment over on YouTube. If you have any ideas for what I can do next, as this is the last class, so there's a probable, 2-3 episodes plus the bonus pack opening episode left in the series, just let me know. This series started off of a viewer suggestion, so I'm always open to them. I'd like to thank you once again for watching. This is Doc Stout. And until next time, I'm signing out.